politics from the Stop the War Coalition to this occupation and this demonstration today. I think what is going on in Palestine today is the greatest war crime in the world at present. Any other country where over 1,000 people have been killed, where they have bombed innocent civilians, where they have done what the Israelis have done in the last 3 weeks, any other country, governments would be in uproar about what has happened. The BBC would be in uproar about what has happened. But our government, George Bush in America, and the media in this country seem content to allow this to happen. There has been virtually no condemnation. When there was a resolution put to the United Nations, the Americans abstained. And we are watching daily people being bombed for no other reason than that the Israelis want to destroy the Palestinians. That is what is happening in Palestine today. And I heard our Foreign Secretary David Miliband say in Parliament this week that Israel is a beacon of democracy in the Middle East. What a shameful thing to say! The 1 million Israeli Arabs have just had their parties banned from standing in the elections next month. That's how democratic Israel is. The Palestinians never had a vote unless they should be displaced from their country in 1948. They never had a vote when the Israelis redrew the borders in 1967. They never had a vote when the Intifada was crushed. They did have a vote 3 years ago when they elected Hamas. They talk about Hamas as a militant group. Hamas is the government of the country. It is not a militant group. Whatever your views of Hamas, they have the right to exist and they have the right to defend themselves against this aggression. That is what is going on in Gaza today. Now, I think what you have done is an incredibly brave thing to have done. And believe me, this occupation will echo around Britain and around the world. Just as our demonstrations have echoed around Britain and around the world. People know we are standing up for justice. We are standing up for freedom for Palestine. That is what this issue is all about. And don't let them tell you this is about Muslims against Jews. It's nothing of the sort. I believe on our mass demonstration last week, there were more Jews on that demonstration opposing what Israel does than there were on the demonstration the following day in support of Israel, which attracted a miserable small crowd. That is because even most Jews in this country understand this is not being done in their name. It's being done in the name of imperialism and done in the name of aggression in the Middle East. What is going to happen now in the Middle East? There's talk of a ceasefire. Well, my view on a ceasefire is this. If a ceasefire means that Hamas has to disarm, I'm against a ceasefire. I believe the only ceasefire has to be a unilateral ceasefire by Israel, where they withdraw all their troops, where they stop bombing the country, and when they allow the opening of the Rafah crossing so that people can travel in and out of Gaza. These are the very minimal demands that we must make. And let's put this into a context. The Middle East is in flames because of what the war on terror has done in the Middle East. It is not going to terrorism, it's made terrorism more likely. It's made it more likely will be war with Iran and with Lebanon. It's made it more likely that Muslims in this country will be harassed and discriminated against because of the policies against what is going on in the Middle East. It's made all of these things much, much more likely. And therefore, this isn't just about one issue, although this is the most important issue facing us today. It's about saying to Gordon Brown, we're fed up with the British government following George Bush, and they are trying to tie Obama's hands There were exiles from Chile. There were exiles from Franco, Spain. All of whom came to Britain because they couldn't organise politically in their own country. The very least we can do for the Palestinians is to demand that they are allowed to come to this college. They are allowed to come to this country. In the way that Gaza is. So it's a very important thing for me that we welcome to Britain every exile who is exiled for political reasons, everybody who wants to come here, and nobody more faces this challenge than the Palestinians today. That is why I urge you to continue your occupation, to join the occupation if you haven't already done so. Stay in the Old Theatre this weekend. Make your message known to the LSE authorities. If they're anything like the authorities when I was a student, they are absolutely up to their necks with big business and all the rotten races. That is what they've always been like. Who'd been the head of a college in white supremacist Rhodesia, now Zimbabwe. They are absolutely up to their necks in all of this, and you have to say we don't want any investment in British aerospace or anywhere else. We want to end the selling of arms. We want that any decent academic institution should not be propping up some of the most disgusting war crimes that are going on around the world. That is why I'd like to wish you every success, and please use this meeting and the meeting with Tony Benn this afternoon to go from strength to strength and to deal a bloody nose to this administration and by proxy to the British government as well. Please if any of you can leave the occupation to come to it, please do. Please come along and speak. You'll be very, very welcome. And please continue to campaign to do everything you can to end these war crimes in Gaza.
Free Palestine! Free Palestine! Free Palestine! Free Palestine!